Hey guys, so here's a close up of today's meal. Poke bowl. I got their poke hot dog. There, it's the hot dog. And then for the first time, I am trying out a spam musubi. All right, guys. Hey guys, so today it is Saturday, October 21st. It is my weekend off and I am slowly getting better from my cold. And so I took my cold meds this morning and I am feeling good the whole day. And because I think my body is slowly getting better from this cold, so I've been very, very hungry the whole day. And I've been like snacking on everything that I'm seeing. I am very not impressed with this hot dog, actually. Because this one is the build your own hot dog. And I asked for cucumbers. Look at the cucumber slivers they put in there. Because I think I'm thinking about the cucumbers because I maybe think it's like the Subway, the way they load it up. But next time I probably won't be getting the hot dog again because it's a hot dog. It's on a soggy bun, so I'm going to eat it first. So, it's the unagi sauce on the hot dog bun. So, I am happy about this hot dog because I'm a little bit weird because all these years I have never really cared about mustard and relish and stuff on hot dog. And I am very glad they got some Asian choices for a hot dog sauce. I am just not happy about the way they loaded up the hot dog. It's not very much toppings at all. And once again, I ordered this from Uber Eats. The hot dog is your standard hot dog. Nothing really too wow about this hot dog is that I won't be ordering that again. So how are you guys doing today? So the only thing only that I did finally was I put my work shirt in the laundry because I had to do that. And I took out the garbage and I took out the compost to the bins. Because I missed it last week because I was sick last week. Like way sicker than this last week. And because nowadays the garbages, they come every 2 weeks. So I have to remember to take out the garbages. So when I have the weekend off, I just remember to take it out and deal with it and forget about it. Not a spectacular hot dog at all. This is totally not your game day. Your football game day or anything, if you have hot dog on your game day. totally not a game day hot dog. Giving a shout out to the Honey Eats. Channel. She recently just uploaded today on Saturday an ASMR on the salmon sashimi. It's like I've never seen a salmon sashimi served like that before. The big ass slice of salmon sashimi. I don't want to know how much that cost. The ASMR sounds of the salmon sashimi is like, if you guys watch that video, you guys will never think of salmon the same way again, because I know some of you guys really like the ASMR sounds and tingles and the sensations that it gives. So if you guys really, really like ASMR, you guys can go check out the Honey Eats TV. No, the Honey Eats channel. I know the Lady T really likes that. So Lady T, go check her out for sure, Lady T. The sensational sounds of the chewing. I don't know how to describe it. It's just so tingly. So this poke bowl, because I'm Asian, so I chose rice on the bottom, and I chose the marinated salmon, some unagi sauce, I think, and I chose some pineapple, and I put corn and carrots on them. Really, really basic, basic hot dog. Because I see a lot of YouTubers having the poke bowl. The first time appearance on my channel is poke bowl. So I want to see what all the buzz is all about, the poke bowl. Let's see how they marinated the salmon. It's like soy sauce. I really, really like it when restaurants, like if they sell burgers or whatever the heck it is you're getting, when they offer the build your own, the custom, I really, really love it though to make it my own. I am a build it yourself kind of guy. And if everybody in your crowd is like that, you can order the same stuff and you could have different versions of the same stuff. Which is very interesting, the custom build your own stuff. This is squiggly stuff, it's a crab salad. It looks like noodles. Now I remember what I ordered. Sometimes I order shit and then I forget what I ordered. I don't even know what I ordered. I got really short memory sometimes. Really, really interesting. So basically a poke bowl is like a salad bowl, a rice bowl. Like the stuff that you see a lot of restaurants out there do these days.
I just don't know what all the buzz about poke bowl is all about, so I just had to try it for once. And this is not the normal drink I usually get, but it came with the drink. I never ordered the drink, so it came with the meal, so it's like, hey, got a free drink with it, so it's like, why not? You guys know I'm a Coca-Cola kind of guy, so this is not normal for me, and so you guys know I normally won't buy Pepsi. So it just came with the meal, so I'll take it. So today the weather for the city here, really, really nice day outside. The last time I checked earlier this morning, it was the 2 degrees. Really, really nice. It's warm enough for tank top weather, 2 degrees, yeah. Canadian style, But of course, if I go outside, I'm gonna put on a hoodie or something, cause outside right now is the perfect fall weather. Perfect for hoodie weather this week. I really don't see much special about poke bowl. If you guys know about poke bowls, can you please tell me why it's so crazy popular? I don't know why it is, but... And this is very weird too, because the spam musubi, the ones that I usually see, it's the whole piece of seaweed is wrapped around the whole thing. But this one is just a little bit of seaweed wrapped in the middle. Because usually I see it, it's the whole piece of seaweed, and the YouTubers, they usually just grab it with their hands. But this one you cannot, you still need to use your fork. I really, really, really like spam though. Yes, I do. I think spam is more like of an Asian thing. But I just don't think the spam musubi is supposed to be served like this. I don't know though, I am getting a little bit bored with the Uber Eats. It's like, I don't know if it's it's whatever address you type in to deliver to. I don't know if it's the area of the restaurants they have, because the restaurants are getting a bit boring. Like, I don't know if I typed in a different address. Like, I don't know if I'm gonna get different restaurants. But right now, for the address I type in for here, I get around, like, not even barely 12 restaurants to choose from. And also, I got the good old McDonald's, so that is a lifesaver. So for a person that does not drive like me, it's very, very convenient service. You know, it's that I could like always not be a lazy bitch so much. It's like I could go to the restaurant, order it, and take it on the bus and stuff like that, but sometimes the stuff that you order, the some stuff might be liquidy, like the gravy or the sauces or something, and when you take it around the movement, the stuff might swish around. And depending on how far you need to go, sometimes it might make a mess, so this type of delivery service is very, very convenient. Yes, it is. I just wish that in the area here, I wish that I had more choices. So today for Saturday, because the cold med is like making me a little bit loopy still. And so there's actually a lot of this stuff on TV today that entertaining me the whole day long. And oh my gosh, I was so happy this morning on TV this morning. They actually had a movie on this morning. I really, really love it. It's like, I think I watched this movie with my ex in the theater when it came out, I think. If my ex is watching this video, you can chime in and make a comment and say if we watched it or not together. The movie that was on TV, it's like that gave me the hot flashes the whole time. It's the Jupiter Ascending, because the Channing Tatum is on that movie. It's like, oh my gosh. It's like, oh, Channing Tatum. Oh my gosh. Ooh la la, Channing Tatum. Oh, oh yes. The Channing Tatum is my all-time favorite celebrity crush. Oh my gosh. I first got acquainted with him years ago. I think he was in the Step Up movie, only the first one. And I remember I was so upset in the second one, the Step Up. I think the Channing Tatum was not in the second one, so I was so sad. I did not bother to watch it. But boy, I think it was years ago, that Step Up movie. And boy, has the Channing Tatum grown muscle, older guy look. It's that, it's that, Who is your celebrity crush? Let me know in the comments below. I'm sure everybody has one. This is like a nice, light dinner, really. And it's not really anything deep fried. It's not like a fried chicken or anything. They actually do give you quite a bit of salmon in this. Would you like a bite? Have a bite of salmon. Have a bite. Yum, yum, yum. Have another bite of salmon. So today, an update about my travel plans. I got the stuff for Barcelona all paid for. The hotel stay for Barcelona and the two tours that I'm doing, so all of that is paid for. And then the travel agent, she set up the itinerary for the Madrid. So that is going good. But boy, though, it's like, the world of the travel industry, right? It's like the way they make you spend money, right? It's like, I got the cruise ship, which is a steal of a deal for 15 days. If you guys are new to my channel, I got in on the cruise for 15 days cruise, and I got it for $1,135 for 15 days. That is before all the taxes. And then, because I've never been to Spain before, so I decided to travel around a bit in Spain. And so the stuff that I pay for in Spain is like almost a double the price of the cruise. And then I have to pay for the flight back home. So the stuff keeps on adding up on top of the cruise. It's like, depending on what type of traveler you are, what you want to do. I know that some people out there, they are very good at it, and they say, nope, I am just doing the cruise, and that is all I'm doing, and after the cruise, just take me home. I know a lot of people out there does that as well. And recently, I discovered this lady on YouTube, and she is very interesting. And she goes on cruises by herself, and she takes the camera around the place and the cruise and everything. And she does, because I think she lives there, and so she does a lot of the European cruises in the different cruise lines, and it's a lot of the ones that I would love to do. But for Canadians, I think it's going to be a little bit expensive, because to do the European cruises, we have to pay for the flight to get there and the flight to get back. And flying to Europe is not cheap for us, so... Like, I've seen a few of the European cruises that she does, and she goes on some really, really nice ships and stuff. One day, I hope to be able to travel like she does. It is like the bliss of life, right, guys? I'm gonna be traveling the way she does. Yes, I am. The video was almost at a 25-minute mark, and the phone does the 30-minute video. So I just paused it, and I started a new video. Oh, man. All this rice and the hot dog will make me go sleepy. Sleepy. Got a really nice chunk of salmon there. And also, I am still on the fence if I want to check out the Sears liquidation sale. I am like on the fence about Sears if I want to go to spend any money there. Because I still would like to go check out if they got any nice bed sheets or anything. Almost an accident. And also, the only thing about the liquidation sales is because it is liquidation, right? So it is not the normal operation of a business, right? So if you guys buy something for liquidation sale, if you guys do not want it or change your mind on it, there is no return on it. So if I change my mind about the bed sheets, I am stuck with it. And so I have to be very careful when you shop at the liquidation sales, yeah. And also, I read on the news article, if you are buying the appliances and stuff from Sears during the liquidation, none of the protection guarantee things would apply to the purchase. So that is the other thing to think about. Ugh. It's crazy though. It's like at the mall across from the place here where the Sears is located. Like they say, it is one of the traditional department stores, and they take over half of the mall space, the complex where the Sears is, and the rest of the mall is like a little bit struggling as well. And it's like when the Sears goes out liquidation, I don't know what the mall is gonna do with such a big empty space. It's like one of those traditional style department stores, and it's gonna be a big ass empty space. I don't know what they're gonna do. Gotta blow my nose. Oh. Excuse me, guys. Got some ASMR sound effects of blowing your nose. These are napkins from the last meal I had. Alright, guys, so thank you so much for hanging out with me today. And it's like, just to let you guys know that my cold is starting to feel better. And so I try out this Pokeball, and it's okay, so-so. It's Pokeballs, like salmon and stuff mixed up on top of rice. It's like, it's okay. And so, just a nice, light, refreshing dinner for tonight, guys. And so, yeah. And so, thank you so much for hanging out with me today, guys. And I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to check out all my other older videos on my playlist on my channel. And I will see you guys soon.